They think we all gonna drown down here. But we ain't going nowhere. The bathtub had more holidays than the whole rest of the world.
This is a magical film. I mean, I don't know how else to describe it, but I was telling a friend, I was like, I think this is one of the best movies I will ever see. So, you know, it's kind of hard to develop questions for it because the movie was so, you know, out of scope of anything that I've, you know, been able to relate to. With you being from home and having the Louisiana roots, how did you guys relate to this story that speaks about the flood and some other things, but it speaks about a lot more?
Well, it speaks about the resiliency of the people that live along the Gulf Coast and the strength that we show under the worst circumstances in the world. You know, we won't give up the people that we love, the land that we live on, and the culture that we have. We won't just leave that just because government said we got to go because of a flood. You know, we love the land, we love the people that we live with, and under the worst circumstances of the world, we are so resilient. It shows the resiliency of the people that live on the Gulf Coast.
Right.
And it's a constant thing that we have to go through. It's not just one particular incident. It's things we have to go through the course of life living on the Gulf Coast. Problems that, you know, we face losing. Just like through the course of our shooting, the BP Earl spill happened and devastated our whole seafood industry, put thousands of people out of work, but we still hung in there tough and rebuilding our industry right now as we speak.
What is it about Louisiana and the Gulf Coast that gives people that resilience? I mean, I lived there once, and when after the floods, everybody was like, well, why didn't they leave? But I understood that culture is like, we're going to ride it out. We're going to stay here. What do you think gives that bond or that closeness to the community that makes people want to stick it out and do that? Like, where does that come from?
The toughness of having to go through these things. When you have to go through these things, I was 2 years old on the roof of the house. My mom had to take us and put us on the roof of the house for Hurricane Betsy. 30 years ago, we was going through these things and we had to be evacuated. So it's a whole series of things that we have to go through that makes us so tough and resilient. So when you have to go through these things, you know, on a regular basis, it makes you tough. You know, it makes you tough and it makes you have a love for the things that you have and the people that surround you.
QUVENZHANE, I read that you're a third grader from Houma. But your character is like so alive in the picture. You seem like you're the most seasoned actress ever. Have you been thinking about being an actress for a long time? And how did this story?
I never really thought about being an actress. I was just like playing with my friends that were on the street because we were friends because of my brothers, and they would just like play basketball, and we ran into each other. So we just started playing since then. So it was actually fun to be with them.
It's not a black movie, like if there's such a thing, but it resonates with everybody. You think that everybody could kind of get something from seeing that resilience and seeing like the magic that happens on the screen between your characters and the bathtub community?
Yeah, because for, you know, just like the people in the bathtub, it's, you know, it's not a black white thing, you know, because they don't believe in Democrats, Republicans, they don't believe in the politics of the world. They live in their own world and they all have their own set of rules. They don't see color, they don't see politics and all of these government problems that the government have. They have their own way of living right there. So they don't see color, politics, and things like that. Yeah.
Okay. Well, Beast of the Southern Wild on my short list for award season this year. Congratulations on a great film, and I look forward to seeing you guys do whatever y'all do.
Thank you.